a fan. The dictionary definition of the word is an enthusiast, a fervent devotee, an abbreviation of fanatic. What comes across to an outsider as a dangerous obsession or even madness is something entirely different from the point of view of the fan herself. To be a fan is a joyous existence, one filled with the happiness that stems from knowing with utter clarity the purpose of your life. But what if that purpose could be more still? If you could be lifted out of the flock as your idol's chosen one, the only one who could decipher his secret messages, what lengths would you go to save the object of your obsession in Night Springs? Tonight's cult classic episode, Number One Fan.
Life's a funny thing. You spend all your time wishing and hoping and dreaming for something, and then, bam! Destiny shows up at your door like a mailman with a package you were pretty sure got lost because you ordered it like 6 months ago. But that's okay. And your destiny has eyes like sunsets and a beard like mahogany-colored velvet, you don't really mind how it arrives. Day didn't start off with all that excitement. It began like any other day did for this waitress slash protector of the town of Night Springs. As always, Night's Diner was the hottest spot in town, so there was plenty of work to do. Hey, it's everyone's favorite waitress!
Look who it is!
My Corgi's. Hi, everyone!
Eat food from this.
Could I get another cup of that delicious special brew that only you know how to make?
Of course. Who else wants a top up?
Me!
Right here, please.
One for me, please, and thank you.
Another cup.
I would kill to have a passion like you do for that writer of yours. You two are destined for each other.
Hot coffee.
I heard your fan site for that writer was named best fan site in the world. Congratulations.
Thanks. It wasn't easy. Here you go.
A person of your genius and grace is wasted serving coffee to us regular Joes and Joannes.
Oh, I don't mind. Here's your coffee.
How do you juggle running this diner, your bird sanctuary, and that amazing fan site for the writer you love so much?
That's everyone's coffee. Better put this pot back. I loved being the very successful owner and operator of the county's most popular diner. But that was nothing compared to my grease fire of passion for the writer and his sheer literary talent and flowing hair and lips like buttery pie crust. Pie! I need to clear the empty pie plates from the tables. Shucks.
My date last night was a total bust.
You're the expert on romance. Any advice?
Yes. But first, tell me everything.
Long story short,
she told me I dressed like a divorced gym teacher.
But it's what's inside that matters, right?
Right. Show them the real you, and it will all work out. Talk about that mole you worry about when you're trying to fall asleep.
Well, I'll try that.
thanks a million.
Don't mention it.
Is Knott's Diner going to enter the statewide pie competition this year?
Of course. We're going to make this our 20th win in a row.
I saw in the news that you saved every single kitten from that bear attack. Amazing.
Thanks. Those yoga lessons really paid off. Those plates won't clear themselves.
The writer was just outside town in that mansion of his. Why don't you go talk to him?
Oh, we have our own ways of talking.
Excuse me.
What can I get borrow you?
Oh. I need a good book recommendation. After all, you're the town's literature buff.
Oh, you have got to read the newest book in the writer's crime trilogy. I'll grab you a copy from the back. Better not crease any pages.
It's me, your favorite writer whose voice you would recognize in your sleep. I'm in danger. Please, my number one fan, you're the only one who can save me.
Oh my gosh. Don't worry. I'm on my way. My beloved writer was in terrible danger, and I had to rescue him. The stakes had never been higher. Luckily, I kept all my accessories in the diner's kitchen. My accessories. Everything a girl needed to claim victory in the battle for love. My bolt-action hunting rifle with a gorgeous walnut stock. Deadly, and looks good doing it. Just like me. My trusty 12-gauge, fully automatic. Extreme circumstances call for extreme shotguns. I was finally ready for a night out on the town, with danger. She needed me. And if that's not life, I don't know what is.
We'll run the diner while you're gone, or we'll be way worse at it.
Woo!
so no one finds it. Nothing would get between me and my future with the writer. Is that?
I really found this rescue.
Who are you? And why do you look like a slightly less handsome version of my writer?
Oh, don't you ever compare me to that worthless hack. Sure, I may be his wild and rebellious estranged twin brother, but we can't all be perfect.
I had no idea he had a brother. To think there were two of him all this time.
After today, there won't be. No more writer, no more books. No more living in a shadow.
But you're his brother. I'm sure you two can... talk it out. And after you change, you can move in together. And I'll come over with popcorn for movie nights.
He had his chance for popcorn and movie nights, but he wanted to keep everything for himself. Too bad. You know what they say? If you can't join him, beat him.
What did you do to him?
I locked Mr. Fancy Pants up somewhere you'll never find him.
You won't get away with this. I'll stop you.
Babe, I got an army of people that hate that hack almost as much as I do. They're ready to die if it stops him from writing another crappy book. What do you got?
I have the power of love.
Oh, is that right? Well, you're gonna need more than your feelings if you want to stop all of us.
Only a monster could be blind to the poignance of my writer's book. Was on her way. Luckily, one of those haters had made a hole in the fence for me.
How did he ever get published?
twins' motorcycle had left tracks in the mud. I recognized the tread pattern immediately, thanks to my famously keen perception. The tracks would lead me right to my writer and his kidnapper. I felt like the detective from my writer's books, solving the case with my wits. All I needed now was an unlimited supply of black coffee and crippling emotional trauma caused by the untimely death of my spouse. Haters. Chapter from the dramatic story of his emotionally troubled past. Oh, that man has more layers than a croissant.
my number one fan. If I don't make it, then I just want you to know that I... No. I can't say it. Curse my cripplingly sensitive artistic nature.
But I love you because you're sensitive. Just hold on. The motorcycle tracks ended at a cabin. Was my rider inside?
Hello? Isn't anyone gonna rescue this poor little rider? Hello? Is anybody there? I'm just a frail rider and I require aid.
He's inside!
And sit through big poetry readings and drink $18 cocktails and have high tea with the queen.
Wait a minute. My rider only drinks coffee. Two sugars, no milk. I keep all the mugs.
Okay. No more tricks. I'll be waiting upstairs.
I bet he's doing all this because he's hopped up on steroids.
Running with wolves seems like a dangerous hobby. I guess writing doesn't run in the family. I have to get down to that beach and get my rider back.
Bike, we're just enjoying the view.
Where is my writer?
What do you even see in that crybaby? He's boring, he dresses like a nerd.
Shut your mouth! He is a stylish intellectual who is in touch with his feelings.
You're starting to cramp my style, babe. And I'm not telling you where he is.
What did he ever do to you?
I already told you that? At the boatyard? I feel overshadowed by success, like he's taken everything I can compete.
Oh, right. I remember now. It's a self-confidence thing.
Well, it's a bit more complicated than that.
You are going to tell me where he is, or else.
Or else what, babe?
You asked for it. You're rude, you have no manners, your too-cool-to-care attitude is attractive initially, but drives people away after they realize you're emotionally incapable of letting your walls down to reveal that you are a vulnerable human being just like everybody else. You are trying way too hard with that outfit.
No, stop! I don't like being seen! Listen, I never had your precious writer. I was just keeping you distracted while my army of haters storms this mansion. Now the love of your life is doomed. Doomed!
No! He tricked me, even with my famous perception.
I knew you, my number one fan, would never fall victim to my twisted brother's lies. His hatred for me is as inexplicable as the sunrise, and just as fiery. But I knew your heart would never waver. You're the only one who can save me. I believe in you.
My writer believed in me. We were kindred spirits. We fit together like a bicycle chain and that spiky wheel thing the chain fits into. We were connected by love and destiny. He was meant to be mine, always and forever. There was no time to lose. I was the only one who could save the writer and the very soul of literature from these evil haters. The fate of all art rested on my shoulders. The stakes had never been higher. That mansion before they hurt a single mahogany hair on my writer's head. Stop your dilly-dallying. My writer is in danger.
Stop you myself, I will. Unlike him, I'm not afraid to get my hands dirty.
This is breaking my heart! We'll be right back.
to kill you? You're my darling writer's brother.
You really do love him, huh? I guess I never even had a chance. I was just jealous of his talent, his money, his velvety hair. But mostly, that he's got the love of somebody as amazing as you.
Too. You just need to stop wanting to be him and start wanting to be you.
Your words have shown me that it wasn't my brother I hated. It was myself. Oh, what have I done? Those haters will tear him apart and it's all my fault. Please, go save him.
Oh, I intend to. Hungry. Jet Ryder isn't going to kiss himself. I mean, save himself. And there he was. After all the fighting, we were finally alone. Together. Our love was written in the stars. And so we danced like two spinning planets that would eventually crash into each other in a dazzling display of flames and rocks and other planet stuff. He told me all the sweet things I'd been waiting a lifetime to hear. I saw myself reflected in his eyes. I would always be at his side to inspire and protect him. He needed me now and forever. After all, I am his number one fan.
A fan and the object of her joy come together against the world trying to keep them apart. A happy ending for some. But is happiness like beauty, all in the eye of the beholder? Where is the line between fandom and fixation? One can never tell. In Night Springs.